I love talking yogurt because with some berries or a banana or a chopped up apple can make a really, really good post-exercise recovery snack for an athlete. And depending on what you're trying to achieve, it's important to have a look and explore the labels on your different yogurts. So in front of me, I've got a high protein yogurt, probably the most popular. And the first to really take the market by storm is Chobani. Over here, Tamar Valley, which is a Greek yogurt, non-sweetened. And this one over here, it's a sweetened yogurt. So what you'll find is that they differ in their composition. And people like say, well, I only eat natural, or I only eat Greek, or I only eat high protein, I don't eat sweetened, or I only eat sweetened. It's a really good idea to maybe mix and match depending on what your needs are. So the Chobani yogurt, it's a high protein yogurt. So the ratio of protein to carbohydrate is about 2 to 1. So if you have a serve of between 150 to 200 grams, which is about 3/4 of a cup or thereabouts to a cup, you'll almost meet your post-exercise recovery needs in a small amount. This one here, the protein to carbohydrate ratio is 1 to 1. And so for every gram of protein, you get a gram of carbohydrate. So going back, 2 to 1, 1 to 1. This one here, the carbohydrate to protein ratio is about 1 to 3. So when you buy a sweetened yogurt, it accelerates the amount of carbohydrate that you eat per gram of protein. So for 5 grams of protein, you get 15, 16, 17 grams of carbohydrate. For 5 grams of protein, you get 5 grams of carbohydrate. And over here, for about 8 or 9 grams of protein, you get about half that, so about 4 or 5 grams of carbohydrate. So it's not a bad idea to mix and match. You use these non-sweetened options as your base, and then you can either add some fruit, and depending on what you're trying to achieve. So if you're trying to increase your carbohydrate needs, you use a high carbohydrate fruit like a banana or maybe an apple. And if you're just trying to get some protein in with a little amount of carbohydrate, then you could use something like some strawberries or raspberries or blueberries. Because if you didn't know, like a fruit serve in terms of carbohydrate, a punnet of strawberries or 3/4 of a cup to a cup of blueberries contains the same amount of carbohydrate as one banana, one apple, one pear. So it's hard to eat a punnet of strawberries, right? Because they're quite low in carbohydrate. So they're a low fueling fruit. Whereas, you know, your bananas, your apples, pears, and similar types of fruits, they're better for refueling because they're higher in carbohydrate. The yogurt over here, your sweetened yogurt, it's good to add on top of an unsweetened yogurt, but it's not something that you want to rely on as your only yogurt choice. So it's good to have a couple in the fridge, either something like a traditional Greek or a high protein Greek yogurt, and then having a sweetened yogurt as well, and using the combination along with some fruit to really start to manipulate what your needs are post-exercise. So you might find that with yogurt, with a dairy-based yogurt, you might not suffer the same upset with your gut as you would with milk. And that's because the live cultures in a yogurt will change the nature or the composition of the yogurt, so it's easier to digest. So it's about mixing and matching and also finding what's comfortable with you. You might also find that after exercise, in that post-exercise window, particularly coming off intense exercise, certain options which you are comfortable with at rest maybe become a little bit more uncomfortable. And that's because your gut is put under stress, particularly during hard, strenuous activity, and particularly in conditions that are in the heat. So one of the best ways to make sure that you're looking after your gut for extended sessions and also sessions in the heat is keeping up with your fluid requirements during exercise, and also making sure that you're taking on a little bit of carbohydrate during the exercise as well.